Did you ever need to make a pivot table that needed information from multiple tables? So for example, you needed to look up the customer code from the master data table so you could bring in the customer description in your pivot table report. The old way to do this was to use a lookup function like VLOOKUP and add new columns to your source data and bring in the information you need from the lookup tables. The better way of doing this is to leave your tables as is and instead use relationships. Let's create a pivot table based on multiple tables. In this lecture, let's take a look at a practical example of using the data model. What we want to do is to create two types of report. Report number one is about customers and their sales values sorted in descending order. Report number two is quantities sold by article. Our data is sitting in different tables. Our main table, so our fact table, is this table right here, which is called table sales. Now, all the information here is just about one company, sales document, document date, customer code, article code, quantity, and sales value. So notice these are just codes. We can find a description for these in the master data tab, where we have two separate tables. One table is called master article. This has article code, description, and color. And the second table is called master customer, customer code, and customer name. Our end report needs to show the descriptions and not the codes. This is where the data model comes into play. Now, we can load these two Power Query and merge them, create one final query, and create a pivot table based on that one single table. But we don't have to if we don't need to apply any extra transformations. And in this case, we don't. Our data is structured in a perfect way. They're all sitting in Excel tables. We don't need to add any columns or do any transformations here. So we can directly create a relationship between these tables. We don't have to merge them. Where can we do that? From the Data tab, right here under Data Tools, we have Relationships here. This green symbol here, this is the data model. When I click this, it's going to open the PowerPivot window, which is our data model. And if it looks like this, it means there is no current data model in the spreadsheet. Then we're going to activate this the moment we create relationships between our tables. So let's do that. Click the relationship icon here and then go to New. Now we need to select our table and decide what is the common column between the two tables. So our first table here is table sales. So notice now it says worksheet table, table sales. Let's go with that. The column that we want to connect to, where there are two, one should be connected to the article master and the other to the customer master. So let's start with article first. The related table is the master data for article, which is called worksheet table master article. The related column is article code as well. Now click on OK, and the first relationship was made. Let's create our second relationship. Go back to New. Our table is table sales, but now notice something changed. It says data model table. It doesn't say worksheet table anymore, because the moment we created a relationship, we added these tables to the data model as well. And we're going to see that in a second. Select table sales. Our second connection is for the customer code, which is going to be connected to the master customer, and the related column is customer code as well. Click on OK. Two relationships were set. You can at any point in time go and edit them, deactivate or delete these relationships. Now we're done here, so let's close this window and go back to our data model, and notice now it's not empty anymore. We have three separate tabs. So each single table that we added was added to the data model as a separate tab. And here we can see how many records we have. One of 20, and here is one of 544. Now this here, this is the data view in Power Pivot. You can add new columns here and create formulas that apply to each single row. But here you can also create aggregated formulas, which are called measures, which are applied to columns instead of each single row. These formulas are called DAX formulas. A good feature in the PowerPivot window here is the diagram view. This actually shows the relationships that we just created in the other window. This is the information about our table sales data, and here we can see the connection. So if I hover over the connection here, we can see the field names that are connected with one another. And here we see the asterisk sign, which stands for many and one. So it's one to many. And here as well, one to many. You can delete relationships from here or create new relationships in this view as well. Okay, but that's it. We don't need to make any changes here. I just wanted to show you how the data model looks after we created these relationships. So let's just leave and go back to Excel. What we want to do is insert our pivot table. Now, when you create a traditional pivot table, you would either select a table or select your data set, go to insert, and then go with pivot table. But when you have created relationships between tables, so basically when you have a data model in place, all you have to do is go to where you want to have your pivot table in, and then go to insert pivot table. By default, you get a selection for use this workbook's data model. Click on OK. Now here we get our three tables all in one place. When I expand these, I see the fields that I have. Now all I have to do is just create my pivot table. Now I'm just going to bring this closer to our data set so we can see it better. To get this bigger, let's just change our view to field selection and area selection side by side. And now let's define what we want. So for the first report, we want customers and sales values. So I'm going to put a check mark for sales value here. And the customer, well, we don't want the customer code, we want the customer name. So that's from our master customer table, customer name, it puts it in the rows, right? So all we did is create that connection, and we can create a report based on that connection. Now the rest is similar to what you would do when you're creating pivot tables. I'm just going to update the name here, change the design to show in tabular format, and update the number formatting to show 1,000 separator, and no decimal places, and OK. Now notice that when you use certain tables here, they become darker, so they're in bold in the all view here. If you switch to active, you can see the tables that are actually used for this pivot table. Let's create our second pivot table. I'm just gonna copy the first one, paste it right here, and then let's just update the fields for the second pivot table. So instead of sales value, I want to get the quantity, and instead of customer name, let's switch to all, go to master article, I want to get the article description instead, right? So we need to sort this in descending order. So actually I forgot to sort this here. So let's right mouse click and sort this one first from largest to smallest. And let's do that here as well. Sort largest to smallest. Let's also update the number formatting to show 1,000 separator, 0 decimal places, and update the description right here. And we're done with our reports. Now, one thing I want to show you is in the data model, if you don't want to see certain fields here, because you don't want the users to use them, or you want to avoid too much clutter on this side, what you can do is hide it from view. If we go back to data and go back to our data model, let's go to diagram view. We can select our fields here, so our columns, right mouse click and hide from client tools. So I don't want to see customer code. I also don't want to see the article code. I can hide it. If you want to hide other things, you can just right mouse click and hide them from view as well, and they disappear from this list. Okay, so basically what we did is we used PowerPivot together with a data model to create these two reports. All we had to do was set up a relationship between them. So this is how you can create a single report that's actually based on multiple tables. Now, this lecture is a part of my Ultimate Power Query course. If you'd like to discover how to use Power Query like an expert right from the start, check out my complete course. Link to it is below. As always, before you leave, don't forget to hit that thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'm going to see you in the next video.